Hello everyone. Today we will be covering FormIt's solid modeling capabilities and what distinguishes it from surface modeling systems. FormIt's modeling kernel was designed from ground up as a solid modeler. Many downstream operations work best with solid models like Revit, visualization apps, 3D printing slicers, and game engines. Of course, FormIt still allows drawing of 1D and 2D elements like edges and standalone faces, the latter of which can easily be extruded into watertight solids. Even when working with solids, it's possible to accidentally or intentionally cause them to be non-manifold or not solid by deleting an owned vertex, edge, or face, or drawing extraneous geometry attached to otherwise watertight solids. The diagnostics in the visual styles palette can help identify this with red indicators to show where solids are not watertight. The flip face tool can help with faces flipped the wrong way, and deleting an extra edge or faces within a solid can help eliminate extra geometry not contributing to the solid. Additionally, while working with solids, FormIt will make corrections and repair models when it can. For example, if a solid has a face turned the wrong way and you modify that solid, the face will be flipped so it faces the correct way when possible. Solid models enable several FormIt tools to work or work better. Many of the advanced modeling tools require geometry to be solid to function, and the extrude tool, drag face, becomes very powerful at subtractive modeling when used with solids. When not used on solids, the drag face tool could result in an inside-out sock result, where extruding just creates more non-manifold geometry. So it's often better to ensure models are solid or repair them until they are before continuing to work with them or sending them downstream to other apps. Modeling with solids also helps keep discrete geometries separate, even if they are touching. While using groups is highly recommended to prevent geometry from sticking to other objects, using solids is an intermediate way to accomplish this. For example, two solids placed next to each other, touching along one face or edge, can be selected separately by double-clicking on each, or turning off all other types in the selection filter except solids, then area selecting over one solid. Let's begin a workflow by making a rectangle for the footprint of the building and dragging the face to the height to create a solid. Using the shell tool and setting the offset to 8 inches, I'll select the one side that will become curtain wall later on, and the bottom and top planes, leaving only what will become the solid exterior walls. Next, we need to add floors to the shell, so I'll draw a rectangle, select and drag the surface up to create an 8-inch thick floor slab, and I'll group the floor and copy it up 3 stories. Since these are all instances of the same group, whatever I do to one, I do to all of them. So let's create a shaft area for the elevator and stairs by editing one of the floor instances by drawing a rectangle and copying it over for both the stairs and elevator shaft. Now if we hover over one rectangle and press Tab, FormIt will highlight the copies of the rectangle as well. If I click to select it, it will select all of them at once, and as I drag down through the floor, it will subtract each of them. Next, let's edit the wall group and draw a rectangle on the face to use for the window opening. Let's array this up to and over 7. And just like the shafts, since these are all copies of one another, if we hover over one and press Tab, all are selected, and we can drag the face into the building to create openings. If we want to edit the jamb location, we can hover over the jamb, press Tab, and select all jambs created from the same rectangle and drag them where we want. Now to add a model group for the windows and array them into all of the openings. On the plaza side of the building, let's draw a rectangle and extrude it from the face of the building. Let's use the Tilt Face tool to angle the face, which will become curtain wall. Now let's shell the front and back.
Now in the interior of the building, we have wall partitions extruded from a floor plan, and if we want to cut the corridor out of them, since they are of the same solid, if we drag the corridor face, it will subtract the extrusion from all walls.
That's it for FormIt's solid modeling capabilities. Be sure to check out more videos on the FormIt YouTube channel.